However, axon particle makes it go round in circular path. So because of magnetic field, this moves in circular path and electric field is not inside these D's. Every time the particle moves from one D to another D is acted upon the electric field. So here you can see there is a very small gap. So when this particle changes the D, let us say this is D1, this one is D2, only then it feels an electric field, because this D is positive, this D is negative. So as soon as this particle comes at the edge of this D, let us say it comes here, so it feels an electric field. The sign of electric field is changed alternatively in tune with the circular motion of the particle, because we know what would be the, here was the frequency of this particle, that was qb by 2 pi m. So we know what is the charge of the particle, we know what is the mass of particle, 2 pi we know. Suppose if we know this b, we fix, if this b is fixed, we know what is the frequency of the particle. In that case, what we can do, we can change this to negative, this to positive, and again this positive and negative. So there was an oscillator just to do this work. So what does this oscillator do? Oscillator changes this positive to negative, negative to positive, positive to negative, negative to positive. So oscillator oscillates this voltage. Why? Because let us see why oscillator does that. Okay, let us see. So this is first D, this is second D. This oscillator is connected. I am showing it upward, but you can show it downward. So initially this D is positive, this D is negative. So particle is started. Since particle is proton, this particle is attracted towards this negative side and repelled from positive side. So particle will move towards this D2. This is D1. And frequency of the particle we know, because we know B, QB by 2 pi M. So this we know, because we know what is the magnetic field that we have applied. So we have applied a uniform magnetic field here, which is coming out of the paper. So this we know, what is the magnetic field. So we know the frequency of the particle. So now particle starts moving from here. Now it moves in a circular path. But as soon as this reaches here at the end of this D, suddenly this becomes negative, this becomes positive. So again it accelerates, and because of this acceleration, its energy, its velocity will increase, energy, so its path will become larger. Again it reaches here, so this again becomes positive, this becomes negative. And we know when this particle will reach here, because we know the frequency of the particle. So now it again moves in this semicircular path. Again this becomes negative, this becomes positive. Again this will move in this semicircular path, this becomes positive, this becomes negative. Similar thing keep on going till the radius of the path becomes equal to D and this particle exits from the cyclotron. So this is the process that is happening inside the cyclotron. So every time the particle moves from one D to another, it is acted upon by the electric field. So only electric field only when this goes from D1 to D2. The sign of electric field is changed alternatively, that we have seen, in tune with the circular motion of the particle, that we have already seen. As soon as it reaches at the end of D, the sign changes. This ensures that the particle is always accelerated by the electric field. So that we have already seen, that particle is accelerated. This is positive, this is negative. When it reaches here, so this becomes negative, this becomes positive. So positive thing attracts, so increases its velocity, V is increased. When it is accelerated, its velocity is increased. Velocity means kinetic energy is increased. ईच टाइम द एक्सलरेशन इंक्रीजेज द एनर्जी ऑफ द पार्टिकल. सो हेयर वी सॉ दैट हाउ डज द एक्सलरेशन इंक्रीजेज द एनर्जी ऑफ द पार्टिकल बाई चेंजिंग इट्स वेलोसिटी. As energy increases, the radius of the circular path increases. So we have seen that as the energy was increasing, the radius of the circular path was also increasing. So the path is a spiral one. Instead of a circular one, if the velocity was constant, the path would be circular. But now here we are accelerating it, so velocity is increasing, energy is increasing, hence path is becoming not circular but a spiral one. This is becoming a spiral one. But again we know that the frequency is independent of its velocity. Frequency, only thing is the radius of circle is increasing, but frequency will remain same. That is determined by only the magnetic field. The whole assembly is evacuated. That means all the particles are in vacuum. Otherwise what would happen? There are too many air molecules. So these particles will always collide with some other particles and will lose their velocity or their energy. So it would be very difficult for them to move in circular path. So that's why this machine is in vacuum, evacuated, to minimize the collision, because you know what are the collisions. Similar we have seen in the gas molecules. So evacuate to minimize the collisions between the ions and air molecules. A high frequency alternating voltage is applied to the D's. So what is this high frequency alternating voltage? This is the oscillator. This thing, what does this thing do? This is oscillator. Oscillator. What does this oscillator do? Oscillator changes this voltage from positive to negative, negative to positive very rapidly. This is quite fast. Okay. So this is quite fast. High frequency. This is very high frequency. Alternating voltage. So this is done by this oscillator. In the sketch shown in figure 4.8, positive ions or positively charged particles, we discussed about protons, are released at the center P. So these are released at the center P. They move in semicircular path in one of the D's. So they started in one of the D's and arrive in the gap between the D's in a time interval T by 2. So where T is the time period of the revolution. So now let us go here. So this was the figure that we have already seen. So they arrived at the D in time interval T by 2. So we know what is the frequency, and from this frequency, frequency is equal to 1 by time period, or time period is equal to 1 by frequency. Let us write this symbol C, that means cyclotron frequency. T is equal to 1 by nu C. C is cyclotron frequency. So we know this whole circle takes time T in completion. This whole circle in completion takes time T. So half circle will take T by 2. That's what they are saying, that in the 1D it will take time T by 2. In one of the D, it will take time T by 2, where T is the time period of the revolution given by this equation. So we have already written what was mu C. Mu was QB by 2 pi M. So just reverse it, 2 pi M by QB. So time period is this much, and time period in one of the D is half of this. That means T by 2 in one of the D. In one of the D, it is pi m by QB. So now we know how much time it will remain in one of the D, then it will reach another D, then again first D, then again second D, and it will keep on accelerating. So this is the time in one of the D. So why this time is helpful? When this reaches at this end of D, immediately we have to make this one positive, this one negative. Then again, when after T by 2 it reaches at this point, we have to make this one positive, this one negative. So that is helpful in determining the frequency of the oscillator. एंड न्यू सी इज इक्वल टू क्यू बी बाई 2 पाई एम. सो दीज टू फॉर्मूले वी हैव ऑलरेडी रिटन डाउन. दिस फ्रीक्वेंसी इज कॉल्ड साइक्लोट्रॉन फ्रीक्वेंसी एंड डिनोटेड बाई न्यू सी. न्यू सी इज साइक्लोट्रॉन फ्रीक्वेंसी.